गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरी स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 10th. द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज नेशनलिज्म इन इंडिया. द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज नेशनलिज्म इन इंडिया सब्जेक्ट हिस्ट्री. इट इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट चैप्टर. दैट इज वाई आई हैव स्टार्टेड. यू शुड लर्न द चैप्टर. वाट इज द टॉपिक? यू कैन रीड इट. द फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर, खिलाफत मूवमेंट, डिफरेंट ट्रेंड्स विद इन द मूवमेंट, टू वर्ड सिविल डिसोबीडियंस, साइमन कमीशन, गो बैक, स्टैंड ऑफ दलित लीडर्स, नेशनलिज्म थ्रू इंडियन एंशियंट हिस्टोरी, एग्जामिनेशन बेस्ड असेसमेंट. दिस इज द टॉपिक ऑफ द चैप्टर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, द अराइवल ऑफ मोहनदास करमचंद गांधी on the political field of India gave an impetus to the national movement and converted it into a mass movement. His method of non-violent resistance, introduction of this spinning wheel and the gospel of the Hindu-Muslim unity drew millions of people into the national movement. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi came our country from South Africa in 1915 at the age of 46. When Mahatma Gandhi came our country, he started a Satyagraha movement. That movement is known as non-violent movement. Gandhiji's theory was non-violent, and he introduced spinning wheel. That is the thinking for the country. That is nationalism, spinning of wheel and unity of Hindu Muslims. Because we know that Hindus and Muslims are both the brothers of India. There are two eyes of in every human beings. So Hindus and Muslims are the eyes of India. Okay, the war expenditure. First World War was started in 1914 and ended in 1918. After the First World War, defense expenditure was increased by the British government and taxes was also increased. The Montague-Clemenceau reforms, it was started in 1919. Underline it because it may be come in the examination. When did the Montague-Clemenceau reforms started? 1919, failed sort of aspiration of the Indians. They further agreed to Indian masses. The defeat and dismemberment of Turkey by the Allies and turn to the Muslim masses against the British government. The Rowlatt Act and the Jallianwala Bagh in tragedy had aroused a wave of popular indignation throughout the country. Next page. This is the map of India. I shall explain it next classes. I shall surely teach you Indian map. It will come in the board of examination, history map. I shall teach you next classes. Okay. Now, in India, the growth of modern nationalism is connected to the anti-colonial movement. People began discovering their unity in the process of the struggle with colonialism. The sense of being oppressed under colonial power was common to different classes, but each class and group felt the effect of colonialism differently. The Congress, under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi, tried to unite these groups together within the one movement. Okay. So Mahatma Gandhi came to our country from South Africa in 1915. At the age of 46, because Mahatma Gandhi was born in 1869 in Gujarat, you know already. He was the leader of India, he was the main leader of India. Next, it is also Indian map. Now I shall discuss later on. Indian map I shall discuss on later on. Point number one, the name of the topic is the First World War. What is the name of the topic? The First World War, 1914. So First World War was started in 1914 and ended in 1918. The First World War created A new created means made. What is the meaning of created? Made. A new economic and political situation worldwide. Increasing problems led to the growth of national movement in India in the number of ways. So what was the causes of nationalism in our country? This is the question. What was the causes of nationalism in our country? Now this is the reason. Number one, the First World War led to a huge increase in the defense expenditure. After the First World War, defense expenditure was increased by the British government. So the British government increased the taxes, custom duty, and introduced the income tax. What do you mean by custom duty? It is new word for you. When the goods are exported and imported from foreign country, at that time taxes should be given to the government. That is known as custom duty. So you should know the terms and introduce the income tax. All such measures which created many economic problems for the people were greatly resented by them, and they thought of liberating their country from the foreign rule. Okay, next page. Page number 38. Again, throughout the years, prices of almost every article increased with the caused much economic hardship to the common people, and naturally they were drawn towards the national movement. Point number three, the forced recruitment in rural areas created an upheaval in the Indian society, resulting in a widespread rancor among the people because their agriculture activities were disrupted and hunger and death began to take a heavy toll of their lives. Four, this war was between England and Germany and the partners, but India was also made a party to this war. This thing was greatly resented by the people. So question is, what was the effect of First World War? This fourth point you should write. So what was the effect of First World War? What was the effect of First World War? Open your book, page number 37. Point number one. Again, point number two, point number three, point number four. Now, Satyagraha movement. Now, I am going to explain Satyagraha movement. Who started Satyagraha movement? You know, I think you know. Satyagraha movement was started by Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhiji's heroic fight for the Indians in South Africa was well known. His Nobel method of agitation and protest based on truth and non-violence was known as Satyagraha movement. So who started Satyagraha movement? Mahatma Gandhi started Satyagraha movement. How was he started? His method was truth and non-violence. This is known as Satyagraha movement. Gandhiji's theory, Gandhiji's policy was truth and non-violence theory. What was the theory of Mahatma Gandhi against the British? Truth and non-violence. This is known as Satyagraha movement. So Satyagraha movement was started by Mahatma Gandhi. Without being aggressive, a Satyagraha could win the battle through non-violence. Gandhiji believed that with the help of non-violence theory, he can win the heart of British. Gandhiji's theory, Gandhiji's policy, Mahatma Gandhi thought that truth and non-violence policy can win the heart of British. In 1916, underline it, very important topic is for the board of examination, underline it. Page number 38. In 1916, Gandhiji traveled to Champaran in Bihar. Where is Champaran? It is situated in Bihar. To inspire the peasants to struggle against oppressive indigo planters. Gandhiji started movement in Champaran. Champaran is the name of a place in Bihar. In Bihar, to support the farmers. What is the meaning of peasants? Peasant means farmers. He inspired the farmers of India. He inspired the presence of India in Champaran, in Bihar, to and for indigo planters. In 1960, Gandhiji supported the peasant. I had already told you what is the meaning of peasant farmers. In Kheda district of Gujarat, where is the Kheda district of Gujarat, who were suffering from shortage of food due to crop failure, and advised them not to pay tribute till their demand of his remission was met. In 1980, Gandhiji went to Ahmedabad to organize a Satyagraha movement among cotton mill workers. So Gandhiji started Satyagraha movement in Champaran, in Bihar, and Kheda district in Gujarat to give inspiration the farmers. Okay, now the Rowlatt Act. The Rowlatt Act in 1919 was passed through the Imperial Legislative Council in spite of opposition of the Indian members. Rowlatt Act gave the government enormous power to repress political activity. According to this act, the political prisoner could be detained in prison for 2 years without any trial. Gandhiji decided to oppose this with Satyagraha. 6th April 1919, observed as Satyagraha Day, when people all over the country observed fast and hartal. What is the meaning of hartal? You know it. Its another name is strike. It was the first country-wide agitation by Gandhiji. It marked the foundation of non-coercion movement. So, non-coercion movement was started by Mahatma Gandhi through Rowlatt Act. What was the Rowlatt Act? Who made it Rowlatt Act? Sir Rowlatt. Who made it Rowlatt Act? In 1919, it was made by Sir Rowlatt. Now, on 10th April, the police in Amritsar fired upon a peaceful procession. It provoked widespread attacks on bank, post office and railway stations. Martial law was imposed and General Dyer took command. Now, Jallianwala Bagh Massacre, 13th April 1919, incident. What is the Jallianwala Bagh incident? Was held in 1919. It is an important topic for the board examination. To protest against the Rowlatt Act and the arrest of their leaders like dear Satyapal and dear Kitelu, when about 20,000 people gathered at meeting in the Jallianwala Bagh in Amritsar, they were surrounded by Gandhi, General Dyer and his army unit, which opened indiscriminate firing, killing thousands of innocent people. On 13th April, I am going to giving explanation from myself. On 13th April in 1919, Jallianwala Bagh incident was held. General Dyer, at that time, was the Governor General of British. He told that fire on Indian people. Indian people were gathered in Jallianwala Bagh. At that time, when the British police fired on Indian people, innocent Indian people, lot of people died on the spot. Very, it was a tragedy for India, Jallianwala Bagh incident. The impact of, what is the meaning of impact? Impact means effect. The impact of the Jallianwala Bagh on the Indian politics. The Jallianwala Bagh had a great impact on the Indian politics. Now the people lost faith in the British rule and took to the extremist path of violent struggle to get rid of it. After the Jallianwala Bagh incident, people lost their faith, people of India lost their faith from British rule. So what was the effect of Jallianwala Bagh incident? After the incident of Jallianwala Bagh, people of India, masses of India, lost their faith from British rule. It was the most effect of Jallianwala Bagh incident. Mahatma Gandhi, with the cooperation of all Ali brothers, Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali, and who spearheaded the Khilafat movement. He launched the first non-commercial movement in 1920. Who were the Ali brothers? Ali brothers, named the Ali brothers, Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali. The Jallianwala massacre or incident had a great significance in the history of India. The incident of Jallianwala was the significance of India. On the one hand, it hit adversely the honor and prestige of the British government, while on the other hand, it marred permanently the government relation with its Indian subjects. It also helped further in promoting national unity, as people belonging to all sections and communities had fallen prey to these atrocities. So what was the effect of Jallianwala incident? After the incident of Jallianwala incidents, people of India lost faith from the British rule. First point. Second point, nationalism was increased in the mind of Indian people. Unity of Hindu and Muslims was increased. That was the effect of Jallianwala incident. Okay. Now, Khilafat movement. During the Rowlatt Satyagraha, Mahatma Gandhi felt that need to launch a more wide movement in India. After the Rowlatt Act, Gandhiji thought that movement should be spread all over India. Okay. But he was sure that so much movement could be organized without bringing the Hindus and Muslims close together. He thought that if there is unity of Hindu as Muslim, that will be effect against the British. On one way of doing this, he failed was to take up the Khilafat issue. The First World War had ended with the defeat of Ottoman Turkey. After the non-commercial movement, Khilafat movement was started by the Muslims of India. Who were the leaders of Khilafat movement? I had already told you, Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali. Who were the leaders of Khilafat movement? Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali. Okay. Now, a Khilafat movement was forced under the leadership of Maulana Azad, Hakim Azmal Khan and Hasrat Mohini, Muslim leaders Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali. So I had already told you, name the leaders of Khilafat movement, underline it. A Khilafat committee was formed under the leadership of Maulana Azad, Hakim Azmal Khan and Hasrat Mohani, Muslim leaders Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali, began discussing with Mahatma Gandhi about the possibility of a united masses action on the issue. Gandhiji saw this as an opportunity of unity Hindus and Mohammedans as would not arise in 100. Gandhiji thought that if Mahatma Gandhi support the leaders of Khilafat movement, there will be increase of Hindus and Muslims. That's why Gandhiji supported the Khilafat movement. Why the Khilafat movement was started? This is the question. Khilafat movement was started because British government, without any reason, attacked the Turkey or Turkey. Turkey is a Hindu word, Hindi words, and Turkey is the English word. Without any reason, British attacked Turkey. That's why Khilafat movement was started from India. Who were the leaders of Khilafat movement? I had already told you. Now, see the Khilafat movement. First, second, third topic, underline it. Maulana Azad, underline it. The leadership of Khilafat movement, Maulana Azad, Hakim Azmal Khan, and Hasrat Mohani, Muslim, and Muhammad Ali, and Shaukat Ali. Okay. Now, the Congress passed the resolution in its Calcutta session in September 1920 to start a satyagraha on the Khilafat issue. To gain maximum success, Mahatma Gandhi proposed a stage-by-stage strategy implementation for the movement. The movement had to begin with a surrender of titles, honors and honorary posts by people. Plan to send or boycott civil service, army, police, British courts and legislative assemblies, school and college and British goods. The British goods were to be replaced by domestic goods or Swadeshi to promote a native cottage industry. In case of government suppression, civil disobedience movement will be launched. After the non-commercial movement, civil disobedience movement was started by Mahatma Gandhi in 1930. This is the main topic: non-commercial movement, civil disobedience movement, Khilafat movement, Satyagraha movement. Write it in your copy. Open your copy, rough copy. What is the important topic of the chapter? Khilafat movement, Satyagraha movement, non-commercial movement, and civil disobedience movement. Now, difference stands with the movement. In January 1921, the non-commercial Khilafat movement started. Various social groups participate in the movement with their own specific aspiration. This movement started with middle class participation in the cities, students, teachers, left government controlled school, lawyers, left court. After the non-commercial movement, many students of India left their school and colleges. Many people of India left their government service. Now, page number 40. How did cultural process help in creating a sense of collective belonging in India? Important question. Nationalism spread when people begin to believe that they are all part of the same nation. How did people belong to different communities, regions or languages develop a sense of collective? You should read the topic. Now, what was the effect of non-commercial movement? You should read, it is your homework. Page number 40, enrich yourself. You should read the topic. The effects of non-commercial movement on the economic front were dramatic. People rejected foreign clothes and handloom sewing up. After the non-commercial movement, who started the non-commercial movement? Non-commercial movement was started by Mahatma Gandhi. After the non-commercial movement, economic position of India became very poor. Economic position became very poor. People of India rejected the foreign clothes and handlooms went up. And people started Swadeshi clothes, which clothes were made in our country. This movement gradually slowed down for a variety of reasons, like expensive khadi clothes were not suitable for poor people, no alternative institution was set up, so the teachers and students finally had to resume their studies and jobs in government school, lawyers joined back in government court. So after the non-commercial movement, people resigned their government service, students left their school and colleges, and people of India started wearing khadi dress. Revolution in the countryside. From cities, the non-commercial movement spread to the countryside. In Awadh, the peasants movement developed under the leadership of Baba Ramchandra. Baba underlined it in Awadh near Lucknow. In Awadh near Lucknow, the peasant movement developed under the leadership of Baba Ramchandra. The peasant movement demanded reduction of revenue, abolition of beggar, and social boycott of oppressive landlord. In many places, night dhobi bands were organized by the panchayats to deny service to landlords of even barbers and washermen. In June 1920, Jawaharlal Nehru began going around the village in Awadh, taking to the villagers and trying to understand their problem. By October, the Awadh Kisan Sabha was set up. It was headed by Jawaharlal Nehru, Baba Ramchandra and a few others. Within a month, over 300 branches had been set up in the villages around the region. As the movement spread, the houses of talukdar, Indian landlords, what is the meaning of talukdar? Indian landlord and merchants were attacked, bazaars were looted, and again holes were taken over. Now you should learn the target learning. you should know the target learning.